So I got an email asking me what is the best way to teach subtraction. And my response was, I'm kind of the wrong person to ask because I don't think we should be teaching subtraction strategies. Now, I'm Christina Tonnevold, the recovering traditionalist, and I'd like to spend the next few minutes talking about the best way to teach subtraction in our quest to build our math minds as we build the math minds of our students. Now, let me explain why I say we shouldn't be teaching subtraction strategies. Because I don't believe that it's our job to directly teach these strategies to students. I am of the belief of what is known as cognitively guided instruction, or CGI. And it is to use the knowledge and understanding of what our students have currently and use that to determine what should be our next course of action. So if you Google cognitively guided instruction, you'll find a whole lot of stuff about it. But the general premise is that we give students stuff in context, mathematical problems in a context, and then just let them solve it and see how they're solving it. And then we use that to try to make their strategies a bit more efficient and to help them become more flexible with their strategies. So, in the early stuff with fact fluency, when kids are doing 6 plus 7, they will start out needing to model 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then go back and count everything. But as they start to learn more about numbers and how they can break numbers apart and put them back together, they start to come up with different strategies based upon their understanding of how numbers work. So it's not so much of teaching strategies to kids, whether it's for addition or subtraction, it's about developing their mathematical understanding and their understanding of how numbers work that leads to them developing these strategies. So that being said, if we're just going to start with a story problem, look at how they're solving it, and then move to more efficient strategies and help them develop those, what are those strategies when it comes to subtraction? And really, again, it's not the strategies. I'm going to talk about 3 key understandings that kids need to be showing to develop some cool strategies for subtraction, right? And it's not just strategies. Again, it's the concepts around subtraction that the byproduct of that is that they will have strategies based upon those. So the first one is that kids need to develop place value understanding. When they understand how numbers break apart into ones and tens and hundreds, they can use that to help them when they are subtracting. It makes the problem nicer if we can subtract our hundreds with our hundreds and our tens with our tens and our ones with our ones and then put those back together, right? They have such cool understandings around how numbers work and around place value that then leads to that strategy. We don't have to directly teach that strategy. If kids have already built their understanding of place value, it's a natural strategy that they will gravitate towards. The second one that I want you to be watching for and building this understanding for your kids is helping them understand the relationship between addition and subtraction. Like, once I learned that you can add to subtract, I never went back. Like, that was my mind-blowing to me, because number one, addition is just so much easier, and sometimes subtraction, trying to do subtraction in your head, especially when you have to subtract a bunch of zeros across a bunch of zeros, that becomes super difficult. So if I can think of it as addition, what do I need to add to get to that amount? It makes subtraction so much nicer. Whether it's with their facts, right? When they're doing 16 minus 7 and thinking of it as, what do I add to 7 that will get me to 16? And then when they move into problems like 10,000 minus 499, if I could think about what I need to add to 499 to get me to 10,000, it makes that problem nicer, okay? So knowing how to use addition and to help them with subtraction. And basically the foundation is understanding how addition and subtraction are related. The third big thing that I want you to be looking for, if your kids have this or not, is the ability to break apart numbers to make the problem nicer. So this starts early on, again, with subtraction with their facts. So like if I'm doing 16 minus 7, and most of the time what you'll see kids doing is counting one by one by one to subtract that. But if they could break 7 into a 6 and a 1, taking away 6 from 16 so much nicer because it gets me to that friendly number of 10, and then take one more away. That also works as we move into more complex problems around subtraction. And it's not just for whole numbers. It's for decimals and fractions as well. It's a very, very powerful strategy. But the idea foundationally is being able to understand that I can decompose or break apart numbers to make the problem friendlier. That's the big idea. So again, there is no best way we should be teaching subtraction. What strategy is the best thing that we should be having kids do? It's that we want to build these three key ideas about mathematics and numbers that help kids with subtraction, and they will start developing the strategies on their own if they have those key understandings. And again, it was place value. They need that understanding of how addition and subtraction relate to each other, and the understanding that we can break numbers apart and then use that to help us make the problem more friendly. Now, if you want to see those strategies in action, I've got a download underneath this video where you can request it, and it'll show you each of those three things and what that looks like when kids are just working with a fact, like 16 minus 7. And then what does that look like when they start moving into multi-digit subtraction stuff, and even subtraction that normally would require borrowing or regrouping, and what that might look like without having to do the regrouping using these strategies that we've talked about. And then I even show you what it looks like as they move into decimals and into fractions, because subtraction is subtraction is subtraction. It doesn't matter if we're subtracting whole numbers, decimals, fractions, or even as they start subtracting polynomials, right, into algebra stuff. Subtraction strategies, the foundation of these ideas, still applies. So I hope this video helped you build your math mind so that you can go out there and build the math minds of your students. And don't forget to request the download. Have a great day.